Hi, this is Peter Newman. We're going to look at building a sheet metal body weldment in ANSYS version 18.1. So we'll start with a static structural base. And we're going to use Design Modeler to bring in a parasolid file. And that parasolid file will contain many sheet bodies, one solid body. We're going to import from the C data boom this parasolid file, generate that. It has one solid and the rest of it are sheet bodies. We're going to put all those sheet bodies into a new part that will be a weldment. And the advantage is the shared topology method will take pieces that, edges and faces that are coincident, and put them common split line, which will help the mesher when it comes time to using the mesh connections. Here's the geometry being attached. And we're going to assign initially all of the thicknesses to be 10 millimeters. Okay, so we want to create a named selection. So we're going to pick all the bodies, but we're going to deselect the one solid. We're going to call that named selection sheets. And in the mesh, we're going to insert a mesh connection group using the sheets, and we're going to use a value of 20 millimeters to search out, to detect the connections to join sheets together, and it's found those. So we're going to go ahead and generate that mesh. And we're going to generate the connections. So what we'll do next is look at edge coloring by connection and observe that we have purple lines indicating the internal ribs and bulkheads are connected, and if we turn off the thick shells, it'll be easier to see that there's yellow indicates four elements coming together, more than three, and that's what we expect to see. And pretty much this weldment is completely welded together, and we might pick this body to hide, and we can see that internally the ribs are welded to the baffles as well. Next we'll check how many elements there are, and there's more nodes. There's 42,000 nodes nearly, and that's too many for the student version to solve. So we're going to take this, show this body and the statistics, 27, 24,000 nodes are just on that one body alone. So we're going to change that body from flexible to rigid, and that way when we update the mesh, it only needs the few elements that are around that body to connect it to adjoining bodies to be meshed. So we'll clear that, generate, clear the data. And in connections, we left automatic contact on, so we actually used mesh connections for that. But these regions we want, what we need to do is have the rigid body be the target, and so these few, this one, well, in all cases, we're going to flip the contact, and now it's happy that this is a rigid body. So, what we have now is the ability to update the mesh. Those contacts were automatically created. Normally, I turn off automatic contact creation as I get too many, but because this only had two parts, the weldment and the solid body, the automatic connections actually saved us some time there. And what we can see now is that the number of nodes is less than the 32,000 limit of the student edition. By changing this part body to rigid instead of flexible, because all the interesting behavior is going to be out in the weldment. What we do need here though is a pivot, so we're going to static structural, we're going to make a remote displacement, and that remote displacement will be on these control click in faces. And that displacement wants to be 0 in all degrees of freedom except X rotation, so it behaves as a pivot. So we've got a pivot on one end, it's free to move up and down in the rotating around X, and the springs connecting these ears will provide the support for the rotation, and those springs go in two connections, and we're going to have a spring that is a body to ground. And the spring is going to be connected to edges. We'll pick these two edges here for one spring, and that is the mobile side. So we're going to have that as one spring, and we're going to take the X coordinate from that and apply it to the other end of the spring, and the Z coordinate we're going to make 42 meters above. So there's the first spring, and the stiffness of the spring is 1 e⁶ newtons per millimeter. And we want a second spring on the other set of ears, so that will be, just repeat insert spring on those two. It's a ground to body to ground spring. It's going on the those two circles. We said 1e6 for the stiffness, and we wanted to take this coordinate and apply that to the other end of the spring and make the z coordinate 42 meters above. So there's our two springs. We've got to apply some mass, and that can be a distributed mass, and it's 60,000 kilograms or 60 tons, and that is going to be on these six edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if we have a mass, we need gravity, so that's standard Earth gravity. There's a wind load on the side, so we're going to put a pressure load on that face of 500 Pascal. I think that's correct. And with gravity, with the mass, got the mesh, we are good to solve. And when we solve, we want to see deformation and stress. So one thing before solving, you only need to do this one time, but open the solve process settings, click on advance, and tell it I have four cores on this laptop. That will cut the solve time in half. So now we can solve. There is a problem. Got a lot of deformation, and probably because I put too much pressure on the side, I got the units wrong. So the units, here we go. 500 Pascal or 0.05 kilopascal is the correct value for pressure. So now we'll just solve that one more time. And it's more like it in units of millimeters. The tip is flexing 31 millimeters, and if we look at the stress, the max stress is right there on that piece, and it's I assigned only a 10 millimeter thickness. The true thickness of that may be thicker, which would reduce the stress in that region considerably. But that is a fully built and solved model in just a few minutes. So we'll save that file and consider what's next.